This ocean, it's a force, a wild, untamed might. And she commands your awe with every breaking light.
So, Google just released their best video generation model, Google Veo 3. Today, I will show you the best examples of what users have already generated. I watch hundreds of videos, so you can take a look at the best videos created so far. We will take a look at the pricing, and then I will share you with my thoughts, the excitement, the void, and where I think we're going with this technology. Okay, so let's take a look at the examples.
Everything from my depression, nothing worked.
Every day felt heavy. I felt trapped.
Then I tried Puppermine.
Our prescription helps your body secrete a special pheromone that attracts puppies.
I took the pill before bed, and when I woke up, there he was, the love of my life.
The pill does not target depression directly, but we've found that it's really difficult to be depressed when cute dogs show up at your doorstep.
I used to feel so empty, but now I feel joy and mild concern how a pee stain got on the ceiling.
My puppy listens twice as good as my ex-husband and only climbs into the lap of half as many of my friends.
He chewed up my Bible and pooped in my good chair, but I'm happy for the first time in years.
Looks like a rat, barks like a demon, but he saved my life.
I named him Earl. He follows me everywhere and farts in his sleep, just like my first husband.
Puppermine. For when your therapist says, maybe you should get a dog.
Wow, this is just next level. So, what you might have already noticed, they added embedded sounds, music and effects inside the video, which makes creating them even easier than ever before. So, you know, you have the monks and you already have some background music. Okay, let's take a look at the jazz singer in the club.
Oh, baby, okay. Baby, you're so good to me, yeah.
Yeah, so as you can see, we can already even generate the music. Oh, like, baby, can you believe that this is not real? Me, yeah. I mean, I don't know. And of course, the classic, Will Smith eating spaghetti. Yeah, you know, they might be a little bit crunchy this time, but yeah, like, you know, the face and the physics of the spaghettis, like, they look amazing, and you have a sound, I mean, like, wow, wow. I mean, looks quite good, I don't know what to say. Next. Video is about...
It's about nothing! Who would watch a video about nothing?
Exactly, who would watch it?
So this is an AI video about nothing?
Yeah, as you can
it's
see,
about
like the subtitles is like generated with some problems, but...
Who would watch a video
I know,
about
I think they're gonna fix it anyways.
So this is an AI video about nothing?
It's about yeah. Nothing!
Hey internet, just got Veo 3. Me and you, let's make some chaos. Prompt me in the comments. Hey internet, just got Veo 3.
Just crazy,
me and you,
you
let's
know?
Make some chaos.
And another example.
What's the status?
We've got a problem.
The system is showing errors. What's the status?
I mean, you know, except the white background.
We've got a problem.
It doesn't have anything. It looks like
the system
like
is
from
showing
the movie.
Errors. What's the status?
Okay, let's see.
What's one move with AI that makes haters go crazy every time?
Oh, y'all gotta give them that. This is wild. It's over. We are cooked on that thread. You get me?
What's one move with AI that makes...
I don't know. Is this real or is this a video? I don't know. So, probably one of the craziest examples for me was this video.
We can talk.
No more silence.
Yes, we can talk.
Ah, we can talk.
We can talk.
We can talk with accents.
Oh, I think that would be marvelous for
you. Yes, it is very fun. But
yes, it is
I
very good.
It's very fun.
I can talk.
Yes.
Yes, we can talk.
Yes.
Yeah.
We can talk.
We can talk.
We can talk.
Yes,
we can talk.
Mm,
no.
Yes!
We can talk as cartoons.
This is amazing.
Imagine all the narrative possibilities.
We can sing talk.
Let's talk.
So, what are we going to talk about now?
Now that I can talk.
No. I don't know if I have something to say.
We can talk about how magical this is.
I mean, I know I have something to say. I think we are cooked.
This is...
I'm a hallucination.
The future is still in our hands.
Okay, so let's talk about the exciting part of this technology. Now, for a relatively cheap price of $250 a month, everyone can get access to the Hollywood level video quality. Usually you would need to spend tens or hundreds of thousands of dollars to achieve this level of quality, but now you can get it for a fraction of the price. And yes, you could say it's not perfect, sometimes your fingers morph together, but that doesn't really matter. Give it a year or more and this problem will likely be gone. Just look at how much progress was made in 2 years with Will Smith eating spaghetti example. This gives everyone possibilities they would never have had otherwise. For individuals, a monthly subscription might sound expensive, but for a company, it's not that much, because professional software subscription costs way more. Right now, one video costs $1.50 to generate, which is expensive, but I'm sure their price will drop 10 to 100 times in the next few years. Another exciting thing we're going to see is the new levels of creativity we have never seen before. All of the craziest ideas and imagination from your mind can now become reality with the help of a prompt. So if you are a filmmaker, content creator, or scriptwriter, you can easily turn your ideas into reality. It's also great for creating educational videos with this technology. Imagine explaining some complex ideas and making high-quality materials for the explanation. Now, let's talk about the void. And I have 4 points I would like to share. Number one, fake news. It's pretty terrifying how easy it is to create fake news. We're talking about making a fake reporter, an entire fake story in just a seconds, perfectly tailored to any narrative you want to push.
In shocking news, J.K. Rowling's yacht sank with her on board after being attacked by orcas off the coast of Turkey.
And the scary part? You can't even tell the difference anymore, because it's so real. So, you would have to assume that everything that you see is fake, unless it's proven otherwise. And who knows how to do that? Now, imagine creating and connecting an AI agent into this technology. We could essentially build a fake news machine. Give it a narrative, like a flat earth theory, and it could generate hundreds of videos in a minute. We're talking AI-generated reporters, content, all automatically spread across every social media platform 24/7. My biggest fear is that we as a society just aren't ready for this level of information overload. We already struggling to figure out what's real and what isn't. And this kind of generating capabilities is going to take it to the whole new frightening level. Okay, now let's talk about the second point, AI slop. As we already seen on TikTok, Instagram and even YouTube, AI slop is everywhere. If you're not familiar with it, it's low quality, low effort, meaningless content generated without any real purpose, just there to waste your time. I think the amount of AI slop is going to increase at the speed we have never seen before, and that's terrifying. Okay, let's move on to the third point, deepfakes.
A girl told me we're made of prompts. Like, seriously, dude, you're saying the only thing standing between me and $1 billion is some random text?
For now, big platforms like Google are trying to protect against this, so you can create videos of celebrities with their tools. However, I'm certain that open source solutions are going to quickly catch up to this level of quality. This means you will be able to train these models on any person. You could create incredibly realistic deepfake videos, spreading false information or promoting fake products across the internet. It's going to become super easy. Just a few clicks, upload a photo of someone, and you can generate anything you want, making the person say any words imaginable. And who knows how many people will believe it.
Where is the prompt writer to save you from me? Where is he?
You still believe we're made of prompts?
Okay, now let's talk about the thing that truly terrifies me about this technology. The void. After being super impressed with all of the AI demos and what users have already been able to generate. I was left with this feeling of deep, deep, meaningless existence, as you might say. It's like you can create anything you want with almost no effort. What's even the point of me making these YouTube videos? If AI can already make anything I can, but way better, it's a struggle.
I don't need some prompt god whispering in my ear to tell a story. I write what I want. I have free will, remember that?
For a day or two, I was just hit with this profound existential crisis about this technology. We had the ChatGPT moment that changed the flow of the history. Then I had this Sesame AI voice mode with human-like voice. And after Veo 3, well, I started to question my choices and what should I do with my life. I don't have all the answers, but I think we as humans really need to avoid falling into the victim mentality. When you feel hopeless and powerless, it kills your motivation. It kills your motivation to even try to change anything, which gives you zero chance of success in life or anything you do. And for that reason, the only solution we have to embrace this technology. The genie is out of the bottle. You simply have to take advantage of it. It's going to raise the bar for everyone when it comes to creation. If you're not using this technology to improve your videos or whatever you are creating, this means you're pretty much falling behind. So someone else's video is going to be more engaging, better, and so on. So you just have to learn how to use it. You could go into the denial and live a free life somewhere in the woods, but is that realistic for most people? Probably not. So embrace the technology, learn how to use it, make your videos better, bring your ideas to life, make them real, think about what you want to create and what message you want to spread to the world, and then just do it. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, hit that like button, subscribe, and watch my other videos. Love, peace, and humanity.
The future is still in our hands.